Fortunately, there are newer drugs, which we think do have some advantages. And lurbinectedin is one of these agents. This is a chemotherapy drug. It's a marine-derived transcription inhibitor. It's based on an extract from a Spanish sea squirt. A single-arm study showed the chance of response about 35%. Now, if we break that down, after you receive initial chemotherapy, if that cancer comes back much later, the chance of response is about 45%, quite high. If the cancer comes back very quickly, the chance of response was lower, about 22%, but still, it's probably the best we have. This led to the FDA accelerated approval in June of 2020, lurbinectedin. It is a chemotherapy agent. It does have a lowering of blood counts. It can cause nausea and fatigue, but overall, this is a drug that's given one day every 3 weeks, and I think a well-tolerated and active regimen. There are studies ongoing looking at developing earlier strategies to use lurbinectedin. For example, this is the IMforte study that I am involved in, where patients receive chemotherapy with immunotherapy, the standard treatment, and then after chemoimmunotherapy are randomized to receive immunotherapy alone or immunotherapy with lurbinectedin. This study is ongoing now. And there are newer agents to keep an eye on. Tarlatamab, for example, is a bispecific T-cell engager. This is a new strategy to try to develop immune responses. This is only available through clinical trials, but in an early report of this study, the chance of response about 20%, but the duration of response was over a year. There are important side effects with all of these agents. For example, tarlatamab can have something called the cytokine release syndrome. And as a result, this drug is currently given as an inpatient, meaning you stay overnight in the hospital for observation. But this is the new class of drugs and one to keep an eye on. DS-7300 is another new agent. This is an antibody drug conjugate that showed a chance of response a little over 50% in a small study. But again, showing the power of some of the newer agents we have. The current standard for relapsed small cell lung cancer, if it comes back after chemoimmunotherapy, is chemotherapy alone. In the US, either topotecan or lurbinectedin. But there are new agents, and I would encourage everyone to consider clinical trials really as the best preferred option for small cell lung cancer at any stage.